Hello, and thank you for tuning in to this online session. My name is Alec Becker. I'm a program manager with Azure Storage on the disk team. And this presentation is about understanding disk I/O and how to leverage disk bursting. So in this presentation, I will be going over an overview of Azure Disks. I'll then be getting into a VM and disk combination mismatch and what that can mean for your performance. Then I'll be getting into some brand new disk I/O utilization metrics. And then finally, I'll be getting into disk I/O bursting and scenarios that it should be used for and how the bursting capability works. So Azure Disk is the best value persistent storage for your business critical workloads. These four unique capabilities of Azure Disk will enable you to seamlessly run your applications on Azure. Azure Disk is the fastest disk scaling cloud. A single Ultra Disk can support up to 160,000 IOPS and 2 gigabytes of throughput while maintaining sub-millisecond latency. This is ideal for lifting and shifting latency-sensitive applications like MongoDB and MySQL. This is also great for applications that require high IOPS and throughput, such as SQL and SAP HANA. We have the promise of never losing your data, and we are the only cloud provider who can say they've achieved a 0% AFR. Customers love the fact that they do not have to worry about data durability with us. We offer a 99.9% single VM SLA for Azure VM leveraging premium or ultra disks. This is the highest single VM SLA for any VM running in the cloud. And with our money back guarantee SLA, you can bet on our disk infrastructure for your applications running smoothly. Finally, we are backed by an innovative and flexible architecture with our Ultra Disk that allows customers to dynamically change their IOPS and throughput based on their workload requirements. And this works great for seasonal workload peaks. This allows you to maximize your performance while also optimizing your costs by provisioning for peak performance when it is only needed. So when evaluating your Azure Disk for your workload, the primary considerations that you should have for it are your latency, which is how long it takes for your piece of data to be written and persisted, IOPS, for which is how many input and output operations that can be made in a second, and throughput, how much data can actually be transferred in a second. Once you have a grasp of your workload requirements for these considerations, you can then start evaluating which disk is best for your scenario. The standard HDD disk is the most cost-effective block storage offering on Azure. It is best suited for dev and test environments and other infrequent access workloads that are less sensitive to performance variability. If you're looking for an inexpensive storage where consistent performance isn't critical, the standard HDD disk is the disk for you. Now, if you need more consistent performance with lower latency, you should go ahead and check out our standard SSD disk. This offers the lowest gigabyte per dollar cost of any SSD on the public cloud. Now, the standard SSD is great for an entry-level production workloads and that require consistent performance. Now, if you're looking for the ability to get higher IOPS and throughput than the standard SSD, look no further than our premium SSD disk. Our premium SSD disk is amazing for production workloads where performance is critical and that requires higher I/O and throughput. Now, finally, if you're looking for the highest IOPS and highest throughput on the cloud and you're looking for sub-millisecond latency, look no further than our Ultra Disk on Azure. This disk also allows you to dynamically scale your storage capacity and performance parameters independently. It is our latest and greatest offering for disk on Azures. Finally, for all these disks, we offer an array of different sizes to help meet your capacity and performance needs. Standard HDD, standard SSD, and the premium disk come with discrete bucketed sizes where capacity and performance numbers are set. However, Ultra, on the other hand, gives you the flexibility to tune your capacity and performance independently. Now that you have an idea of which disk to get for your production workload, once you have that figured out, you also need to choose the right virtual machine to match this. This is because virtual machines have their own storage I/O limits and therefore are the other half of the equation when it comes to storage performance. Sometimes a VM is not sized correctly for the storage performance needed for an application, and this is a scenario that we call VM I/O capped. So let's run through an example of how this would actually play out. So right here, I have a D48S V3 VM that's capable of handling 1,152 megabytes per second of throughput. And then attached to it, I have a OS disk that can handle 25 megabits of throughput and two data disks that can handle 900 megabits per throughput each. So I have an application that's running on top of this. And the application comes in and says, hey, I've got a request for 1,825 megabytes per second of throughput, which is the sum total of all the disks that are attached to this VM. However, the VM can only handle 1,152 megabytes per second. So the VM has to turn this request down when processing it to the data disk. So the OS disk gets its request of 10 megabytes per second, but the data disks have to come down to 571 megabits per second. And the data disks see this request and they say, okay, cool, we can respond back with what we've been requesting. These get back to the VM level and get summed up to 1,152 megabits per second. And this is not ideal. This is VM IO capping, where the application is requesting an amount that the disk can all handle, but the VM cannot handle this. And a solution for this would be to upgrade your VM to a VM that could actually handle this type of throughput request. Now let's take a look at the other side of the coin, where the disks are the limiting factor, and where this is what we call disk IO capped. So here we have the same VM and we have an application running on top of it, and it requests what the VM can handle, the 1,152 megabytes per second of throughput. So they come through to the disk and this is all fine. Now this gets shoveled off and now we're dealing with P30 disks that are attached and they are all data disks. And so now when this gets to the VM, it gets split up into different requests to the different data disks at 384 megabytes per second of throughput. And the data disk goes, hey, we can't handle this. And so what they're gonna do is respond back with what they can handle at 200 megabytes per second of throughput. And then when it gets to the VM level, that'll get summed up into, there we go, 600 megabytes per second of throughput that gets surfaced to the application. And this isn't what we want as well. This is where we're getting limited by our disks that are attached to the VM. And so a way to remedy this would be to either add more data disks to P30 data disks to the system to allow for additional throughput, or to upgrade these disks to larger size premium disks or up to ultra. So now you might be asking yourself, how can I tell if I'm being disk IO capped or VM IO capped on my VM and disk combination? Well, now we have these wonderful new IO utilization metrics that can help you do this exact thing. How these metrics work is they take the amount of IO that is happening to your disk, and then it divides that by the amount that is allotted by this disk. This essentially gives you a percentage for how much the disk IO is being utilized. So this is done for both bandwidth and IOPS, and it also is done on OS disks and data disks. Further, by Q3 of calendar year 2020, we will have IO utilization metrics available for VMs as well, where this will be a utilization for both IOPS and bandwidth on both the cached and uncached storage IO. Now let's take a look at these storage IO utilization metrics in action. So in this demo I've set up, I've gone into the Azure portal and set up a VM, the standard D48S V3, which is the same ones that we've been going through with the examples in this presentation. And then on it, I've got one OS disk that can do 200 megabits per second of throughput, and then five data disks that can do 200 megabits per second of throughput. So we're going to go ahead and connect to this VM via SSH. And then we're going to run a disk IO load using FIO to stress test all these disks. And what FIO is telling us near the bottom right now is it's running at 700 or 800 megabytes per second. And this is nowhere near what we're seeing. We should see around 1100. So we're going to go into our metrics tab and we're going to take a look at those new IO utilization metrics. So we're going to look at the OS one first. And let me change my time frame here. And we're going to take a look at it. And it is being utilized to 100% of its capacity, which is what we want to see. So let's go ahead and take a look at our data disks here. And we're seeing it at 60%, and that's overall for all across the data disk. So let's apply some splitting so we can look at all the data disks individually. And here we can see the ones on LUN 4, 0, and 1 are being utilized at 100%, and the ones at 2 and 3 are not being used at all. So to remedy this, we could either switch the data path over to FIO to make sure the ones on 2 and 3 are being used, or we could add the ones on 2 and 3 to a storage pool that 4, 0, and 1 are using to make sure that they are being 100% used as well. So if you're seeing high utilization, bursting can be a great solution for this as well. We have disk bursting feature, which allows resources to go above their provisioned or uncached limits for 30 minutes a day. On the disk level, we have a bursting feature enabled for our premium disk up to our P20 disk, which is a half terabyte. This bursting feature allows you to burst your throughput up to 170 megabytes per second and also allows you to burst your IOPS up to 3,500. This comes enabled by default, so all you have to do is just attach your disk and you get your premium disk and you get your bursting feature. It is based on a credit-based system, and I will go over how this credit-based system works on the next slide. Now on the VM level, we offer VM level bursting on all LSV2 series VMs. We give you the ability to burst your throughput up to 8 times its uncached amounts. Again, this is for 30 minutes up to 30 minutes a day. It comes enabled by default, and it is also a credit-based system. And today, I'm also pleased to announce that we are unveiling this VM level bursting on all DV3 and EV3 VMs in select regions. And this will be available in the West Central region, and we plan to roll that out to more regions soon. Now, this bursting feature allows you to better optimize your performance and cost, because now you can provision for the average IO instead of provisioning it for the peak. It also allows your VM or disk to handle unforeseen spikes in disk traffic, so you can have your peace of mind knowing that your disks and VMs can handle spiky traffic. And if you want to get the latest and greatest about where this feature is all rolled out to, you can go to aka.ms/disk bursting. Now let's get into how this bursting credits are earned and used for our VMs and our disks. And to do this, I'm going to run through an example. And we're going to run through an example of a P1 premium disk. And the P1 disk is provisioned to do 120 provision IOPS. And it can burst up to 3,500 IOPS. And just FYI, the disk and the VMs also come preloaded with all the bursting togets when they're spun up or started. But in this example, we're going to assume that our bucket is empty. So in the beginning, the P1 disk is sitting idle for 10 minutes with no IOPS happening to it. So it'll initially fill up this bucket with 120 IOPS per second. So we begin to fill our bucket for 10 minutes, and then all of a sudden it sees a spike in traffic and it needs to go and burst up to use, and it can use these bursting tokens that are now in its bursting bucket. So now it can go ahead and use these tokens it's accumulated, and it can burst up to this 3,500 IOPS for 20 seconds. And that's how the bursting credits are earned and used. Now let's go ahead and see this in action. So let's see this bursting in action. And what I have provisioned here is the L64SV2, which has bursting enabled up to 2 gigabytes per second. And then I have attached to it enough disk to do 2 gigabytes per second of throughput. So let's go ahead and SSH into this VM. And just like the previous demo, I will be running a stress test of FIO on it to see how much throughput we can get on it. And so let's go ahead and run this FIO test. And then at the bottom, you can see right there that we are getting, we're getting 2 gigabytes per second of throughput. So please feel free to reach out to myself or my team at azuredisk@microsoft.com for any questions related to disk IO utilization metrics, disk bursting, general disk questions, or general storage questions. We'd love to help you. Thank you so much for tuning in, and take care.